Yo, what's up, everybody? You are now listening to From the East Side with Love. JC, I couldn't go with the beat, obviously, with that. But
How you knew I was going to ask you that when you couldn't match that first? Hey, it's your boy, JC. I'm fresh off the Diablo. They call me Diablo.
Yo, JC, so basically, you hit me up and said, hey, man, we got to honor your boy, Ye.
I don't think I used the word honor. I don't know about honor.
Hey, man, you said he dropped that classic about a decade ago. We're going to have to talk about it. You know you got to talk about it. You talk about you being a Ye stan, you got to talk
Whoa,
about
hey,
it.
Whoa, hey, it's a lot of words. This is exclude this two of them. That's a perfectly fine sentence. But it's been 10 years since I am this damn long time. My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy came out. Holiday season, 2010. We're at 2020. The world is ending, so we got to relive the classics.
We got to take you all way back to November 5th, 2010. Almost exactly 10 years ago, Kanye drops his fifth album of his historic catalog. And I believe Billboard was saying this album was the greatest of the decade. The 2010 decade, bro.
Yeah. Stands the test of time.
People arguably say that this album is his best work collectively.
You can definitely say that.
What are we talking about? We talking about College Dropout, Late Registration, Graduation, 808 and Heartbreaks, My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. Jesus.
Nobody counts. Yeah, you could have stopped right there. Nobody counts the rest of that trash. But you can say there's not many people, especially in hip hop, who had a run of what we'll call them arguably classic albums back to back to back to back. You gotta look at, when you look at hip hop, you look at Ice Cube, when NWA, America's Most Wanted, Death Certificate, I can't even say Death Certificate. And then Predator. Niggas will argue Predator. But Kanye, you don't argue against Kanye's four albums. My four or five run. Niggas will say 808s is a classic now. When it came out, niggas argued against it. You don't argue them first three. And then the cherry on top, the, what would you call that? The peak of Kanye, my Dark Twisted. Then it's been a downfall ever since.
That's what JC said, but listen to what Kosher say. Kanye has been dropping bangers since arguably what, 03, 04? Now, Kanye has been a trendsetter, whether it's in fashion or in music, and has literally changed up his style. Even this album wasn't anything that we sounded like in his previous albums. So now the new Kanye that, you know, people say, hey, I want the old Kanye, and then compared to the new Kanye, he's just been switching it up. He's been switching it up. So at the time, they felt like this album, basically, like looking back, Kanye perfected his craft for this album. I remember there's a song that we're going to talk about later on where Kanye was so obsessed that he had to have like 50 artists on that track. You remember that, JC?
Yeah.
And so I think with this album, though, as a whole, you know, it was so melodic. It was so dope. Because this was around the time where he started dropping Good Friday, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so when we heard the Good Fridays, then we started hearing like, yo, Ye's in his bag, bro. This is probably prime Ye back then, because everything that he touched at that time was, you know, just it hit the highest. Like, anything Ye was on, there was no touching it. I don't remember when Watch the Throne came out. You remember when that came out, JC?
Mm-hmm. A lot of hype.
Well, yeah, but do you remember, like, what year? Did that come out before or after this?
Came out after. Remember?
Okay, came out after. So that's probably the highest rap Kanye we've seen since. Well, arguably, what, a couple of years after this album came out?
That was probably right after.
Okay. But this album, as far as a sonically sound music, I'm sure every album that Kanye puts out, if he plays at a stadium, no matter what, it's going to go crazy. But this is probably like stadium status from front to end, JC.
And this is officially where he stopped making beats. He did not make a single beat on this album.
Mm.
That was a change from Graduation. This nigga let his boys take advantage of it. And this is when Kanye became a producer. More so in the range of, you know, Dr. Dre. Where Scott Storch can say, hey, I made this beat for Dre, but that sounds like Dr. Dre. Well, you know, he'll take credit for it. And this is Kanye as a producer. You know he can still make the magic, but as you can see now when he had the little July album, what was that, June, July albums with Pusha, with Nas, with Tiana Taylor. There's some misses. There's some doubts if you can still make the beats. Some doubts if you can still produce at a high level. This album right here, this was him producing some classics. I mean, we're talking about Dark Fantasy, man. It's produced. The beat is made by, you know, No ID and the RZA. And there's a few versions originally when the song came out. So Kanye got to add it. I guess Kanye was adding what my man said, that stadium. So when you hear that shit in the stadium, that shit'll echo out. It'll reach the fans in the nosebleeds. But like Kosher said, ain't nothing sound like that. Because when you go to Gorgeous, these niggas is rapping in auto-tune the whole damn... Who raps in auto-tune the whole sound? Got the guitar. A lot of guitars in this shit. What's Kosher favorite kid, Cudi on the hook? Hey, the surprise feature, the chef, Raekwon. I'll give it a Kosher. Rapping wise, this is also peak Kanye going into Rosh the Throne, where he arguably killed Jay-Z. Well, I won't say killed, but wounded Jay-Z on every track. That was when we were at our Nas stands at our highest, because hey, Jay was watching this period, all the trash albums he was dropping. Then Kanye kill him on Rosh the Throne. Woo! I enjoyed it very much.
The way the government treats says, I won't be satisfied to all my niggas get it.
Get it? So JC has argued with me on many of occasions where he says, yo, Kanye's old music was more conscious than his new music. And I'd be like, nah, bro, like, it's just a stream of consciousness, man. Like, you know, Ye's an interesting dude because, you know, you'll hear he hadn't made a whack verse, arguably, until The Life of Pablo came out. And The Life of Pablo, when that literally came out, like, that hurt. Because I at first, I thought Yeezus, when he put out Yeezus, I was like, good grief, what is going on here? But then, it's an acquired taste. You actually like Yeezus, or I like Yeezus the more time I played it. I've told this story many a time. You guys, if you guys have been following us, you've heard this story many a time. Yeezus and Born Sinner came out around the same time. J. Cole's Born Sinner. JC, myself, and my cousin, we are driving to Vegas. That's a 4-hour trip. Right? Yeezus, we're listening to Sway in the Morning. And what's my man, the G Unit DJ, JC? DJ Who Kid.
That's your Haitian brother.
DJ Who Kid. DJ Who Kid, and I'm going off a little tangent, but bear with me. DJ Who Kid and Sway and all these people on Sirius XM, they were like, man, I don't know what's going on with Yeezus. I don't know what's going on with Yeezus. And I was hurt. I was like, yeah, man, I actually like Born Sinner more than Yeezus right now. But then later on, I started coming back, listening to Yeezus, and it became just a dope album. I say all that to say this. The lyrics in this album, it don't miss. It don't miss. Ye came through on every track. And has been coming. He came through on every track or every album before that. So that verse right there on Gorgeous with that guitar, though, it killed it. It killed it, B.
And this was 10 years ago. He can't rap like this anywhere close. Not even 50% capacity. It's over, rapping wise.
I don't know about that. But you want to hit that next track real quick?
Might as well go on to everybody. Well, this was the official first single. And you remember he dropped the video. It was a 1-minute video. It was so popular.
What did he call it? I think he literally called it a motion picture.
Mm-hmm.
In that 21st century, doing something mean to it, do it better than anybody you ever seen do it.
Scream from the haters, got a nice ring to it. So this song, JC, when this song came out, bro, you can't tell me you weren't a Ye fan when this song came out, bro. You came out, dog. Everybody had their theme music. Hey, I swear I must have heard at least, since this song debuted, JC, I must have heard at least 100 movies play this song as a soundtrack, bro.
I'll be honest, it really didn't hit me when it came out.
Really?
It didn't hit me. It took the remix to get me to come home to it.
Oh, bro, hey, can you cue up that remix, bro? Hey, shout out to that nigga Kobe, because Kobe was in the studio when this remix came out, bro.
Let's see.
But while you looking it up, let me know when you cue that up, and then I'll switch off. But power, bro, power, and I ain't talking about that 50 Cent show. This was before the 50 Cent show. This probably fueled the 50 Cent show, bro. This song, man, you talk about stadium status, bro. I've been to several Ye concerts, my nigga. And when you start hearing that, niggas be doing that chant, everybody look at each other like, And bro, when I tell you, bro, niggas can literally have the chant going before that. Like, the people will force Kanye into that song because the whole arena will start humming the chant. And Kanye be like, all right, bro, that's what you want to hear. Let's play it. Like, he ain't never do that. But that's how powerful that chant is. You got it, JC? So, all I'm saying is that this song right here, man, when it dropped, bro, this was my Teflon, bro. This was my vest. This was like, you can't tell me nothing, which was, you know, a song alluded back to his third album, or excuse me, his second album, Late Registration. No, wait, third album. That was a Graduation. Yeah. So, no, wait, what? No, that was
on the second album. Correct.
Yeah, it was on the second album.
What's crazy is Kanye did the same thing with Can't Tell You Nothing, where he only released 30 seconds of it. And as you know, one of Kanye's most legendary verses, he asked the honest question. He said he had dreams he could buy himself to heaven, but when he woke up, he spent it on a necklace. He told God, I'll be back in a second. It's so hard for me not to act reckless. That's how he released. And he's like, God, this, my nigga rapping like this? And you didn't hear that beat. But that Power remix, man. Let me give you a little bit of it.
All right.
I want to know who decided to use this beautiful sample. Hey, yo, man, stop playing with people, man. They want to see you act all crazy in this motherfucker, man. Take that jacket off and get all crazy on the niggas, man. Yeah, I'm talking about it. What would mean to be the boss? It means take a place. First one he lost. The crucifix. Your nails to the cross. Crucifix. It's a hell of a cost. Do it, bitch. I'm about to hit that death goal. Jordan, the only one more important. But I be feeling like Jordan when I'm recording. Cause every time I record, I duck about the board. I don't know what these rappers gonna do after war. Probably sounds like I might do a the award. I got the whole crowd going crazy. Homie, I should be rewarded. Getting money easy, how you doing, huh? Getting weak, so you think you being greedy, huh? Don't even think you can allude to the rumors. I'm immune to the fools. I'm a fool. No, they can't rap like this no more. They can't rap like this no more. My little sister, she can't see my little sister. Number one sound across the board. Hey, number one sound forevermore. Hey, number one rule is niggas don't hate. Baby, I dropped the album, nah, y'all gotta wait. And on the net, they showing pictures of my Cali face. I think they're getting wild, but it still got the Cali face. All my old girls know that I'm oh, first little deck of Drake. Classic beef.
Swiss Beats, Kanye West. Like I said, shout out to the Mamba. They were all in the studio when Kanye made that album or made that song. And I remember that came out in the cut too. Like, we weren't even expecting a remix for that, bro. And I mean, fire. Oh, well, what more can you say? It was just fire. People still will play this. Like, I don't even know if people even know the Power remix existed like that, because people love the original so much, though. And I would love to hear Kanye rap the Power remix in a concert, but I don't know if he's had, at least any of the concerts I've been into, he hasn't. But fire, like I said, fire. What's that next song? We got All the Lights.
I remember they made a big deal to show everybody who was featured on this track. Start off with Rihanna, because you got to start off with Rihanna. Rihanna and Kanye don't miss until recently. Then that was a big miss. That was Kanye's fault too, not Rihanna's. No, if Kanye put lights on the song, hey, don't miss. Nigga batting 100% from the plate. Now, this is a definition of stadium music. Well, you're supposed to sing that hook along with him, screaming to the top of your lungs. Probably got the lights flashing and shit. This shit probably hype. Ah, damn. But who was taking chances like that to have that many different vocals featured and be able to get somebody to agree to that shit?
I don't think people understood what he did right there. You know, JC, I don't know why you looking. Can you see how many people? I could name the people that I remember. Literally, I didn't even have to look this up. He had Rihanna. He had Elton John. He had Fergie. He had Drake. He had Alicia Keys. He had Kid Cudi. Literally, each person that I mentioned, each has like a little, maybe it might even just be a word, but they were all literally featured on this song.
Nigga had the Dream on that shit too? Oh, nah, Vocal Dream. No, you had RLS on that bitch. You gotta have Charlie Wilson and Kanye Don't Miss as well. That's 100% at the plate. Yeah, it's probably on this album. We'll get to that later, where this nigga Charlie Wilson just pops up. And it takes the track to another level. He saved the song on Yeezus as well. Niggas only like that because of Charlie Wilson. I'll say that on the record. But we're going to have to get to the next track, because I got some questions for this nigga Kosher. I need answers, nigga.
Till it's right out, won't just another lonely night. Are you willing to sacrifice your life?
And before you even hear the verses, Nikosha, who had the best verse on this song? You can take your time thinking. Who had the best verse? Stop the music too. I don't want you to get your memory with y'all. Who had the best verse? You can be honest with your heart.
Look, I will be honest. I will be honest. I like.
Oh, this nigga's caping already. Let's answer the question. Who had the best verse?
I'm gonna say Jay-Z, I'm gonna give you, but I like that line. I like that line from Jiggy. He's like, all them blood suckers. Like, the way he said that, like, I just like that part right there, yo.
I don't have any words for you. This nigga said, JC, let's hear this trans verse. This one of the worst verses in this catalog. This nigga said, Jay-Z. Godzilla, King Kong, Loch Ness, Goblin, a zombie with no conscience. Question, what are these things all have in common? Everybody knows I'm a motherfucking monster. Conquer, stop your silly nonsense. None of you niggas know where this fuck is. None of you niggas have seen the cuts that I've seen. I still get you screaming. My tweets, murder, with black convertibles. I kill a block, I murder the avenues. Rape, pillage, and village, women and children. Everybody wanna know what my Achilles heel is. Love, I don't get enough of it. Sound like Drake crying on the track. All I see is these niggas I made millionaires. This how Drake raps now. I'm like, I tell you how that's why it's bad. This is how Drake raps now.
Well, you know what? I don't even. Come on, bro. That nigga Jigga came out and named a whole bunch of monsters and said, what do these niggas got in common? Come on, bro.
An answer a 3-year-old could answer? that was time for the real correct answer. Who had the best verse?
Pull up in a monster, automobile gangster, with a bad bitch that came from Sri Lanka. Yeah, I'm in a tanga, color of Willy Wonka.
Color of Willy Wonka. Watch the queen cocker, nigga. The money ain't kosher. No album out. Little Easter, you know that's hot, nigga. He spelled it for you, coach. He spelled it for you. I don't know. How can you deny that verse? The different flows, the actual bars, the punchlines.
I don't deny that.
You said Jay-Z who had the worst verse. Rick Ross' verse was better.
Nah, and that nigga had two bars. I told you one line,
which is a whack line at that. You lost it.
Look, I know what you gonna say, man. I know you love that Nicki, cause I know you ain't like I know you ain't never heard another Nicki.
Hey, that don't need to be disclosed. What's going on here? That don't cover up that you want to acknowledge the queen. Acknowledge her.
Oh man, Nicki. I remember when people heard that in the beginning. Niggas like, yo, Nicki served them up back then.
This is even true now.
I'm not gonna hit on the verse, bro.
You crossed the line. You crossed the line, my nigga. Just throw Charlie Wilson on the track, elevated. You ain't telling the truth. That's what we're learning in this podcast.
Nah. But I'm so appalled that you even said that, bro. That's how we gonna start off the transition. Because I know for a fact that you weren't paying attention to that Nicki verse until niggas told you afterwards.
Just know Nicki had the best verse. It's like that from Jay-Z. What the best verse here? Be honest. You're just up again. You gonna pick Jay-Z again? It's like that sometimes, man.
Ridiculous. Life can be sometimes ridiculous. Huh?
Hey, he let you know he was working with Donald Trump back then.
What?
He let you know he was working with Donald Trump back then, my nigga. Gotta listen. Third eye.
When people heard this song,
you gotta remember. At first it came out with just Kanye verse, and then Tiger and Chris Brown they did their little freestyle over that shit. So you're hearing this beat. This beat is I like at the concert. This nigga have dragons on stage spitting out fire, my nigga. That's how I thought it.
Hell yeah.
It sounds like some epic mythological shit. Some legendary rappers on the track.
Darius, what? We got Kanye. We got Jigga. We got Pusha. And we round out the bass with Saha.
His introduction.
And remember, Saha's introduction. And remember, I love the story for Saha. Kanye left the verse out, or Kanye left the music on the loop or something. Saha walked into the booth and said, nah, I got it.
But that shit at the end.
I gotta come home, dog. I got all these niggas on here. Now, you want to say who had the best verse of the last song? People say Nicki got the best verse of the whole album. Who had the best verse on this song? No, JC.
I've been riding with Pusha. It's just every one of his verses. I got this. We'll get to the track where I feel is the best verse on the album. And that's coming up.
JC, I remember anytime Pusha was featured on a song with Jigga, Pusha said he always had a gift.
Did.
I think there's another song with a brown paper bag where I think it was Jigga and Pusha. And Pusha was like, I'm about to snuff this nigga, man.
Hey, Pusha was getting that nigga. I'll give Jay Drug Dealers Anonymous. He got Pusha finally. Pusha killed that shit. That was Jay finally like, damn, they saying you killing me on all these tracks, my nigga. I got to get you back.
I like Saha debut. I'm not gonna lie. I think Pusha got this too. I think Pusha got this, but I like Saha debut because it. My nigga was like, who is this nigga?
It was Beyonce who said that verse because he was like, who is this nigga on this verse? I like this verse. So they stuck that shit on there.
Yeah, because it was quotable, though. It was quotable. Everybody was saying that little March, May, April chose to March thing, you know?
They really won, my nigga. I kept the city's best. Yeah. Never said she was the brightest either.
Your Highness, I speak the gospel hostile.
Another powerful line. I speak the gospel, but it's hostile. I got that.
We gave you Bobby Brown job. I gave you a Bobby Brown job, dog. No home, no course. Spill it. I owe you all.
The legendary verse by Pusha, man.
We gonna play that. We gonna ride out to that Saha. Saha. Another Swiss Beats hook. Huh? I am so outrageous. If God had an iPod, I'd be on his playlist. Thou shalt not hate, kid. I told JC, I was like, JC, are we gonna play the whole song of So Appalled? JC said, Hey bro, how could we not?
This shit came out on a Good Friday too, and niggas was just like, this is what you got on this shit? This is what you pulling on the album?
Hey, who this thing at the end, though?
This is the scariest part. Where the hell RZA come from? This damn rapping voice.
This track was dog. I mean, you can't help but to like move your head to it. Nah, just whole body be swaying like, yo. When JC said that Kanye was a producer, bro, like this album to me was like We Are the World back when they had to do those telethons or whatever they were called. Where, you know, back in the day when there was like all the best singers, they were like Michael Jackson, Rod Stewart, Prince, and they had just a collective of all these great singers back in the day. And you know, when there was a tragedy, they would all be together and do something and do a sing-along. And Stevie Wonder and all these people, Whitney Houston and all that, were all in there. And they had to, you know, they were raising money. And I feel like Ye's one of the few artists of our generation that had that kind of connections and was able to put people together. Like JC, another tangent. You remember Started Up with Lloyd Banks, R. Les, Fabulous, Kanye, like who would have thought that, bro?
That came out of nowhere. Nigga reached, I forgot who reached out. But then Lloyd Banks appeared on the Good Fridays. What's that? A Christian Dior flow? Just, you gotta think of Christian Dior flow. The niggas he had on that track. And then you hear Lloyd Banks kill his shit. Then they went on to do Started Up. Goddamn, that was a run. And I want to really break down what it means when Kanye produces a track. We can go to the easiest prey, I would say, is DJ Mustard. If you guys ever heard the original version of Big Sean's I Don't F*** With You, it's just missing something. And then here comes Kanye, hearing Big Sean's album, like, let me help you with this check, my nigga. And all he did, add a little sample and slow it down. And that's what years of engineering, that's what years of mixing, the ability, that's what niggas call Dr. Dre the goat of this shit. He don't have to do anything, but he can hear and it changes a little bit. It slowed down. Who would have thought just slowing down that beat would change the dynamic of the song? And he did it again to DJ Mustard with Rick Ross. I don't forgot the name of the song. What's the song called? Sanctified. All he did was slow that shit down.
Oh.
Added the sample. And you remember the intro to Sanctified. It gets you in the mood. That's what producing this with Kanye. Because, again, so apart. There's a different version of what Tiger and Chris Brown was rapping over as when it's time to lock in and make it really knock in the stadium. And obviously, so Paul, it sounded like dragons is flying in the sky. It sounded like some shit that Game of Thrones should have played when they had to put the Queen of the Dragons to work, my nigga, in the better seasons, not the trash seasons. And then we're on the run right here. We started off so apart, not a weak verse. And it leads into pretty much, I would say, one of the greatest beats of all time. Maybe even the greatest beat on the album. He don't even wait, my nigga. He come right out. He knew. I love you, though. Put your hands to the constellations. The way you look should be a sin. You're my soul, Coco. I know I'm preaching to the
congregation. We love Jesus, but you done learned a lot from Satan. Satan, Satan. I mean, a nigga did a lot of waiting. We ain't married, but tonight I need some consummation. May the Lord forgive us. May the gods be with us. And that magic out. So. I don't, you know, it's crazy because, like, I don't know what song that I have a favorite, what my favorite song is on this album, bro. There's just so many parts of this album that's just like, yo, I like this part. I like a whole track, you know? It was no misses, bro. Like, we went from Power, which you could be arguably say that's like the height of many people's albums, bro. And yeah, it was like, I ain't done yet, bro. I'm gonna keep going. Then he brings out All the Lights. Then he brings out So Appalled. Then he hits you with Devil in a New Dress. And we know that Rick Ross has a affectionate. He has a good ear for beats. And Rick Ross always, Justice League, they be killing it. All the Maybach music, all the Aston Martin, whatever. We know Rick Ross don't let down on beats, bro. So when you hear this, you're like, yo, Ye in the bag, bro. Ye came in the bag. Then you see who featured on it. It's like, oh, it's Rick Ross? The Boss? Okay. So what we gonna do on this? What we gonna do on this track? The beat already sounds clean, JC. You not mad about this beat, JC. You like, okay, you know, I like this, what I'm listening to right now. Ye spitting on the in the background. You be like, all right, my nigga. I heard JC tell a girl when he was drunk, you my sensation, you know?
It's legendary. We gotta give credit to the beat maker Bink, as he's made countless classics. Starting with Rockefeller, saw him and Kanye. I'm ready.
JC, you ready?
Bink made classics of Rockefeller, Just Blaze, them niggas. Then Kanye went to, this is when Kanye becomes the producer. Like, let's add more to this. What else can you add to this? You know, you got the piano, my nigga. You really need the guitar, my nigga. Then you need the guitar, my nigga. It's the theme of the album. Got Mike Dean on the guitar. Then one of the most legendary verses.
I mean, out of nowhere, the Boss comes through, bruh. Tell me, who was it? What black kid was it having an air guitar out when they heard that? Like, my Ross comes out of nowhere, like, what? Had cyphers with Yeezy before his mouth was wide.
It's a legendary verse. Maybe the best verse on the album.
Oh, so is this the best? This is what you got in the best beat. Verse on the album, bro?
It's that voice. It's the cadence. It's everything. It's a perfect flow.
Ow.
A legendary song. I can pick Brave. This is my favorite track on the album. If I make a mix, the shit always gets on it. God bless the man I put this ice over. Who can deny this? Still got my Coogi too, my nigga. I don't know, man. It's legendary. It's one of the most legendary songs. Every time you knew niggas and you knew blacks, you did a Kanye list, and somehow this shit be losing to some shit that Kosher listened to today. Wow. Kosher can't find a song that's Kanye's released in the last 10 years that can match this in any possible way. Production. Nothing. This is the highs of the highs.
Nah, bro. You wildin'.
I ain't coming.
You wildin'. It's coming. It's, don't worry. Like,
Jesus will come before it's that coming, happens,
bro.
Money.
You know that you ain't got
in the times that happened before that happened.
Yeah.
That's a good excuse. Nah. In the times, my nigga can't get Kanye no more. You swimming in fire, my nigga. He ain't got time to do it.
Anyway. Nah, this nigga. Oh wow, yo, you can't say that to a man that's born again.
I'm gonna be born again.
You tripping? All I'll say is this, man. Ye got it in the bag. Don't worry about that. You just refuse to. You refuse to give it a chance.
It's whack.
That's what it is. You know, you were trying to turn your back on Ye since 808 and the Heartbreaks, bro.
Hey, T-Flop was whack.
That's what it is. All right, bro. You always be
this is the nigga because he had yo. No, it ain't funny. He had a chance. You know what's funny? Father, stretch your hands. That is pretty much. That should have been one. That should have matched it. That is one of the greatest beats wasted of all time. I say it on every podcast. We talking about sports. I'll say that shit.
I'm not. Yo, I'm not going to hold you. That really hurt you, bro. That I understand. That hurt me too. I'm not going to not under like that hurt me. But you like Ghost Town, bro. And you were so hurt. You said this is how I know Ye is finished. I Ghost never Town heard anybody else talk about Ghost Town.
At least a top 10 to hit. That shit did nothing. That's when I knew it was over for that nigga. Cause Ghost Town is the perfect hook from Cudi.
Yep.
Cudi singing his heart out, Kanye singing his heart out, and this shit just came and went. And I knew it was over. And then, I mean, we all knew it was over. That's why he's in fashion. Ain't no place for him in music. Then he just dropped some shit with 2 Chainz and what's the other nigga named Baby? Niggas ain't talking about this shit. That's the 2 most popular niggas out. Niggas ain't talking about
this shit. You know what, though?
Kanye not included in the 2 most popular.
Well, you know. No, and that song is cool though. That's the thing. Like, it's cool to hate on Kanye.
No, new blacks love Kanye. I don't know how you can know. New blacks love Kanye.
No,
they love
new blacks don't love Ye.
Yeah, they do. Because new blacks turn their other cheek when in front of racists. He's nice. That's a new black. And Kanye is racist. He's working against the black people. He's working against his own people. It's a new black.
Oh, please, bro. Please, man. You sounded like Tay. You sounded like
Tay. We'll get back to Zama because, again, we're on an incredible track run with the next track. Jeez. Like, how do you even track Devil?
I don't even.
In a new dress? How do you even top it? You bring out the piano.
You bring.
Kosher had the pleasure of seeing this live.
People hear this, and know what it is automatically. This one note. Don't even got to hear the rest. Just know the note. This is like Kanye Shakespeare right here, dog. His Mozart. His Chopin.
Then you get to this track, then you remember, like, God damn. This may equal Devil in a New Dress. This is just an incredible beat. This hell Kanye giving in to the hatred that the ladies have for him. He said, we're gonna have a toast for niggas like you, us new blacks. I'm like, he ain't say new black. Kosher definitely sent some emails out, got caught. Don't put that on record.
This guy, man.
Kosher hates them good girls, too. Not Runaway. This is, again, definition of stadium music. You put this shit on, and the crowd just goes crazy. There's no denying the epicness of the song. It's a 30-minute song, and niggas don't even care it's a 30-minute song. Make it an hour, my nigga. That's how epic the song is. Can you just listen to this shit? That's what niggas do on YouTube. They loop their favorite part for an hour, 10 hours. The niggas be listening to that shit. That's what niggas do to Wolves. They just loop the shit forever. But Jesus, then you get the Push. I told you Pusha didn't miss with his verses on this album.
So Kanye, this album was interesting, right? He plays this on the 808, this verse, I mean this beat, and just goes ham with it. I think he released like a short film with this. And people are like, whoa, it was like a ballet. Then he shortened it and made it a music video. And you know, you can't tell me Kanye wasn't a creative, man. Kanye was pushing the bounds of music.
Did I say the greatest hard on hoes verse? It's hard. Like, how you tell your girl either leave or deal with it? It's only two options. Right back to them knockoffs.
And Pusha was very vocal about this verse too. Pusha said the first time he heard it, told that nigga to go back to the back and write it again, yo. Kanye wanted a distinctive verse where he said, yo, if the girl don't hate you by the end of your verse, bro, I don't want it on the album. So I believe Pusha said he had to write it like two or three more times. Before Ye said, yeah, that's that savage I want out of you, my nigga. I need that. And this is probably one of the first times you ever hear Pusha not talk about that wife.
Talking about that lifestyle. That flashy Pusha. The legendary Pusha price. Oh, yeah, nigga. This nigga, he did. He did a short movie for the whole album. What's that model name? It's a beautiful model. She was a star in it. But it was for the whole album. I mean, Michael Jackson did it first. Prince did it first. There it is.
Was it Selena? Was her name Selena?
It is. A great album. Like they said, they didn't say it was the decade's greatest for no reason. The peak, we'll call it peak Kanye. The peak that can never be reached. Mount Kilimanjaro. The Himalayas.
you know what's crazy though, JC? We know a lot of artists. And there's a verse right here where Kanye just being sounded like he drunk. We know a lot of artists have music in their catalogs where we'll never hear, right? We know Kanye got a thousand versions of songs that we'll never hear. You say that's the peak Kanye. That's just the peak public Kanye, probably. Because we don't, bro, you know how much music Kanye got. Like, it was like sad when Good Fridays ended, bro. Because it's like, yo, we like these songs were never going to be on an album. He just started releasing them. Everybody was waiting for Friday to hear a new track. How much
I can
more
just say
Kanye
2010 is peak Kanye,
world,
JC? And anything after that is a steady, 100% incline. Think about when COVID pop off, how the stock market dropped. That's the kind of drop I'm talking about. Hey, Kanye's giving everything to music. Not many niggas can say they got, I mean, just unarguable classics. Kanye, you can say Kanye got four. Not many niggas can say that. He's done it all. It's okay that he's finished. It's okay. He's still top 10. One of the greatest producers ever. This resume speaks for himself. It's just he's finished. He's finished. Who? You said Drake is what? Drake don't produce. I don't say that. That's not hard, nigga. Drake ain't got no classics. But Drake beat him in a battle. Drake make better music than he do right now.
Okay. I'm not about that. But the thing is that...
Yeah, I just told you in the damn... What song was that? Oh, the Power remix. They keep arguing about the damn car. That's the Drake. You got the dreams money can buy where Drake said, hey, I don't see you in that car, bitch, nigga. And then Kanye came back on Watch the Throne. You ain't see it because I'm in my other whip. You know these lines, my nigga. They kept talking to each other.
All I know is Drake said that. He got
maybe he does in music Kanye. Right now. You seen what Kanye did on the Billboard since 2010? The damn, that's literally the fall of Kanye. 2010, Drake took over. So it's Kanye's fault. You should blame you should blame Kanye for Drake taking over. Since 2010,
this I blame the New Blacks.
You're part of the New Blacks, my nigga. I know how you vote.
I blame the New Blacks.
But damn, we get into the next
Canadian
track.
Nigga take over.
That's one of the culture's favorite songs as well. I might as well play it for the streets. Again, we still on the guitar, my nigga. Guitar ain't left. On the record, that nigga Kosher did fall in love with a porn star. That's on the record.
You see, this song right here is like, this is like Father Stretch My Hands. But the thing is that the Father Stretch My Hands, when you hear that, like this at least fits the theme. The title says what it is, Hell of a Life. So you expect that lewd, that raunchy, that nasty stuff. Well, when you hear the Father Stretch My Hands verse, you're like, what the hell?
It's safe to say it was sacrilegious to say such things on a gospel track. No wonder why he had to be born again. Nigga had to repent for his sins.
Oh, man. You can cut that song off, JC. This is not one of my favorite songs. You know, it wasn't a bad song because, like I said, it fits the theme. The title, it fits the title. But to me, it was like, I could arguably say it was a throwaway because I didn't really care to hear all that. But it was what it was. Like, he said, again, the title explains exactly what he's going to talk about, and he talks about it, bro. And it was the life he was living at the time.
Exactly. Being with Amber Rose, you got to live a hell of a life.
Oh, man. But then he goes back. We talk about pianos. This is probably arguably one of... I can honestly say I'm surprised that JC... JC, what was your favorite Al song? You said it was The Devil in a New Dress, or was it just... Okay. I'm surprised JC didn't say this next track was his favorite track, because JC to this day be humming this. Just humming this beat. Out of nowhere, too.
Who's fault? Let's play the game. I love you. Boy, let's play the game. Sure. Let's call our names. Names.
I remember when JC was going through relationship problems, he would just play this song. I heard him call girl bitch for short too. At the first resort too, dog. Heard a girl call him that too, dog. You know we both from wrong. That's probably the last time John Legend and Ye were in the studio together.
So mark of a great producer, because the original song by Apex Twins, it ain't a song piano, my nigga. This shit just sounds somber. Melly Collin.
And Ye. And it wasn't even like a hard verse. It was just like,
so I saw that frustration with Amber. Less of classic music.
Hell yeah, it did.
I ain't been asking for help for 10 years. Y'all niggas won't help him. If y'all fuck fans' fault, he's asked for help. He didn't want to listen to this nigga.
What was 808 in our base? Yeah. Was that about his first girl? Kanye makes some of the best music when he hurt.
He ain't pussy like Drake and hides it for himself.
I think it's a stick around and real feelings my surface. Choking you. I remember you said that. From the local dude. And then this nigga Yang got just randomly puts Chris Rock into the song. Like, I remember that it was so crazy that Chris Rock just ended up in the song. That nigga Rick Ross. Did you ever hear the story? Like Chris Rock said about the Rick Ross, like the Rick Ross thing. So, ever since Chris Rock did this. Like, people love this little skit, whatever you want to call it. I guess he must have bet Rick Ross, or something happened, and he lost. And Rick Ross was hunting this nigga down, bro. And Chris Rock says it like, Rick Ross said, either you get hemmed up, or you do a skit on my album like you did Ye. And obviously the nigga said, hey, I'll give you a skill like I did for Ye, my nigga. Like, don't have me up, my nigga. And so Ross, and that was like 10 years later, bro. Like, that album just came out, whatever Rick Ross and Chris Rock did his little skit on the Rick Ross album. But Rick Ross, like, he said he was avoiding Rick Ross forever, bro. And then they just ran into each other. And Rick Ross was like, hey, man, I'm going to have you up, bro. You were trying to avoid me. And Chris Rock like, hey, man, whatever you want. I got you. Just don't have me up. He's like, hey, give me that skit, bro. Give me that skit. It's like, I got you. Chloe Mitchell. I remember JC. This is JC's vocals.
Good vocals. Right? I'll take credit then.
Let's call out names. I hate you, my heart. Let's call out names. Names. Sure.
I remember you told a girl you can't love her that much, dog.
I can't love you this much. I can't love you this much. I can't love you.
Hey, hold on. I'm going to have to replay that, dog. You're going to have to let the people hear your vocals, bro. Go ahead. Don't shy from it, bro.
I can't love you this much. Dress. Yeah, that continues the story. That's a nigga worst fear. That's, and I got a homie who's literally, that's his fear. Like, he done leveled this shit up, and then some next nigga who ain't on the same level get the shit that I didn't talk to. That nigga be real angry about this shit sometime, my nigga.
I didn't know that's for sure.
You that the Kosher know the homie too. He seen that nigga in the tub getting emotional. She give him nightmares.
This is some circus so late pussy now. Shit. You don't want all Pluto on a nigga, okay? And I love it. And I thank you. I thank you. My dick thanks you. How'd you learn? How did your pussy game come up?
Easy taught me.
I was fucking parts of your pussy I've never fucked before. I was in there like, oh shit, I never met him before. I've never even seen this part of Pussy Town before. It's like you got this shit reupholstered or some shit. What the fuck happened? Who the fuck got your pussy all reupholstered?
Easy reupholstered, my pussy.
You know what? I gotta thank Easy. And when I see that nigga, I'ma thank him. I'ma buy the album. I'ma download that motherfucker. I'ma
shoot a bootlegger.
That's how good I feel about this nigga. I still can't believe you got me this watch. This motherfucker is the exact motherfucker I wanted. You with the bezel? This is the motherfucker I wanted. I saw this shit.
JC got me a watch like that, dog.
Shit on in the sauce. I remember Twista had this motherfucker on in the sauce. That's right. That's right. Yo, babe, yo, this is the best birthday ever. Where you learn to treat a nigga like this?
Easy taught me.
God damn.
Easy taught you well. Easy taught you well.
A lot of pain in that track.
What's interesting is that JC would always tell the girls that Easy taught you, huh? You told that to every girl afterwards, huh? You say that to every girl. Yeezy taught you. Girls would have that on the headlines. Yeezy taught me. And it's interesting because Ye was talking about a girl, a blonde dyke, since what? Stronger, Power, whatever. Stronger. Been talking about that for like 8 albums, and then he finally gets her. And I didn't even know that. This is revelations. I mean, I figured it was true, but. JC confirmed that she.
Kanye, honest man, he got bad tracks talking about Kim too. Like before they even got together, everybody knows the story. How long he been after Kim? Honest man, in his songs. I give you.
I like your boy Drake. Drake want to make Drake will literally make a story up.
All he had to do is release the Rihanna pain, and I would just say he had a classic. Did he do that? No.
What's that other girl that he liked? That 18-year-old girl, or is she not? That's
Georgia
anymore,
Smith.
But... Yeah, he loved her. He could release that.
Like, he did, but it's just it didn't hit. It was a song called Jaded. I told you, he just sounds narcissistic on it, my nigga. I can't enjoy it.
Yeah.
Ain't that no sooner than later, brand new pain.
Oh yeah. Well, you know what? My thing, I mean, I'm just gonna say this and then we're gonna go to the last track. The thing with to me about new Drake is that he just sounds bored on every track out here. He just delivers, but he don't sound hype anymore. He don't sound anything. He just knows his. He just stays a perfectly like well. Like he don't. I don't be hearing that like that.
Nigga
that
don't rap no more.
Music
man.
Like that. He don't. He just talks. He just be talking. But that's enough for Drake, man. You be love trying to intertwine Drake with these Ye stuff, though.
That's two songs left
of the album.
Lost World. Will We Survive?
Oh, what? Oh, you got.
When Will We Survive? One in the Lost.
Oh. You can play that one, though.
Which one you got queued up? Lost in the World? Next. Yeah, that's the second to last. Go ahead.
I got Lost in the World.
He just took you on an emotional roller coaster. So he gonna level you out.
To slow down time. I'm building up to slow down the night. I'm lost in the woods.
I'm down on my
land. I'm building up to slow down the night.
I remember Kenny was like, "Mama say, Mama say, Mama say." I said, "This nigga, JC,
the crazy Kanye versus." I still remember my mom and my cousin discussing Michael Jackson. Like, what decided for this nigga to say this shit? Like, no. How did this nigga come up with some shit like this? You my hell, my nigga.
Wow. I remember JC wrote a poem just like this. I said, "It sounds familiar, dog." Gave it to a girl.
So known for that, too. I'm going to be honest with you.
Run from. I'm moving the city.
That's how you mellow the album out. It took you on highs. Let's ride
yeah,
out.
Basically, right. Like you can feel it coming to an end.
Ten years. Album was considered a classic the day it dropped. All these tracks sound like they could be released today and still be successful. That with Kanye though, he's finished, but you know, somebody else would be sitting there.
This guy.
Like Drake.
There's literally no song on this album that you could be like, I mean, for me it would be Hell of a Life. Like if there's one song on the album, if you can find one, which one would be the lead?
That'd be Hell of a Life. But if Kanye released Hell of a Life today, I'm back in the team. That's how this just works on the album.
It works. No, you're right. That's the thing. Like, I can't hate the song because that's what it was. Like he was living crazy, and Ye was known for that. Like Ye had this like, I guess I would say like a what was that one song where he said I live a Brad Pitt reputation, that rah rah, like. That's the song. That song. That's what I'm thinking of. Like, Ye just, you know, being crazy. Oh, yeah. That's what it is.
That's another Charlie Wilson track. Ooh.
Yeah. You got that. Who Will Survive in America? I got it. I got it popped up right now.
Who's gonna play? You gonna play?
I got you.
Ended on one of culture's favorite men. Sound like Kanye need to listen to this today. Instead of being a new black.
This guy. Hold on. Who will survive in America? Who will survive in America? So that's Gil Scott-Heron. Also, Bon Iver was on Lost in the World, and Bon Iver was hot back then as well. I remember that. Ye ends the album with a Gil Scott-Heron, and I didn't even know there was bonus tracks. I don't remember See Me Now with Big Sean.
We don't count Taylor that Wilson. Officially.
I don't remember. Okay, and then. The Runaway film, the short film, Hype Williams directed that 35 minutes. That's just another little tidbit. But JC, I mean, we literally listened to the album front to back. We went on this journey with the people. 10 years later, it's still getting revered. You know, people, the Billboard, the music industry love this album. Wish Kanye could go back to that. You knew they black don't. Someone that.
No, they like the new Kanye.
I'm talking about you too, though.
I don't.
Nah, man. You don't like the new Kanye. The new Kanye. The new Kanye is real, though, bro. The new Kanye.
Sure, I can't.
Bro, he's you can't hate music. The new Kanye, man.
He's terrible at music.
Hey, hold on. Hey, people. Let me ask.
Wow.
Hey JC, did you listen to that Joe Rogan episode? Exactly. That's what I'm music. Right there, people.
It's not music.
If y'all listen to that Joe Rogan episode, huh?
No, man, he can't make good music. That's my whole argument. He can't make good music anymore. It's over. Sure, he can talk good. Why couldn't he? He probably prepared his life for that shit. can't prepare music though.
Nah, you hate the way he talks, just like you hate his music.
Man, you can't do music.
That's
it's
what
over.
I'm saying, bro. Ain't nothing Ain't nothing wrong with
it. He barely on it. That's why. That's why nothing wrong with it. He barely rap. He know better. Like, yeah, I will never doubt Kanye producing. The man knows what he's doing. That's Kanye. I can't support Kanye, to that, bro. Why Kanye don't want you to support him on Def Jam? So you know, it's a win-win for me. It's over for him musically. Oh, yeah, that's okay. All I'm saying, musically. I wish his endeavor is happy everywhere.
He gonna be your next. He gonna be your next president, bro.
He can't beat The Rock. Like, how you who are you beating? He can't beat The Rock. This nigga can't beat The Rock.
Oh yeah, he'll beat The Rock.
Man, if Kanye ever really got put, they were putting The Rock out just so that nigga can lose embarrassingly.
Oh. Nah, The Rock ain't running, bro. You better off saying AOC gonna stop.
All the point is, Kanye, one of the most legendary rap albums, pretty much albums in general. I don't listen to other artists outside the hip-hop genre. Maybe Arcade Fire, where the run is just incredible with albums. We have a Lil Dragon, which is non-stop classics.
The thing is that I'm glad you said that. It's not one of the best rap albums. This is one of the best albums, period. And I'm glad that you kind of touched on that the fact that, you know, people got to realize y'all don't want to give rap its place and due, but then you follow the culture and try to cross it over. And then all of a sudden it's like, oh, well, we'll take this part, but we won't recognize the music. Because, and Saha kind of pointed that too. He's like, how can you go against Adele or these bands, because they don't recognize rap as that type of level. And Kanye shows you, and Kanye been showing you that it is that type of level. Kanye has no problem collabing, producing, orchestrating, you know, stadium hits, and you can put his music in any type of genre. And if people like music, they will like Kanye. Because Kanye, at this particular time, wasn't making any misses. So, at the end of the day, you know, I don't know if it got album of the year. It probably didn't. It probably got only rap album of the year. But, you know, America shows its face back then, because this album had everything you wanted. Everything you wanted. Singing, guitar solos, violins, rapping. Like, there was nothing that was missing. And it had all your favorite artists, all your favorite pop artists on this album. Right? So, and Ye used different, it wasn't just rappers. That's the thing. It wasn't just rappers. Like Kanye can transcend, cross over boundary lines, music genres, and make it work. And that's the thing that he actually been doing forever. You know, we go back to Late Registration, and he'll take Adam Levine from Maroon 5 when they were popping. He puts him on his first verse. He puts him on his first song, heard him say. Ye is an incredible, innovative genius in the fact that, again, he sees what's hot, and then he'll like, hey, okay, well, let's make music together. And the music sounds lovely. The music sounds lovely. And this is just another example of a solidified album, a beautiful album. And I'm glad that he's getting all the roses now, because, again, it's a shame when people look back and be like, man, that was a great album. And that person is long gone.
The nigga who made this album is long gone and missed. We'll never get that level again.
JC, I would argue, bro. I would argue that that person's still there. You just gotta give him.
He'll never fumble the Nas album. He's still there.
That Nas album, man.
How Hit Boy do a better album than Nas, my nigga? Can you answer that?
It wasn't.
I like that Hit Boy album he did with Nas.
You don't like Nas anymore, bro. That's the thing. All of a sudden, you like that now? You hated like the last two Nas albums, and then
you
definitely don't like the Kanye Nas album. But Kanye gave dog. You listen to Tiana Taylor and Kanye, dog.
Oh, the non-Kanye track.
You like that album? What are you talking about?
He gave a classic with Pusha.
Nigga wild, bro. Oh, Daytona. Nobody can talk about Daytona, bro. That was rap album of the year. That's a rap album. That was rap album of the year, and I am so sad that he lost it to, I think, Cardi at that year. He lost it to Cardi. But I get it, man. Probably Drake put that call in, like, hey, man, don't give that nigga that album. Don't do that to me. So I'll give him that. And then I think Big Sean was in that too.
Big Sean was not in that. Hit Boy was in that. Hit Boy's in everything.
He wasn't? No, I'm not talking about that, nigga. I'm talking about the live. Nah. Like, it wasn't a Nas.
No. Big Sean don't get Sean, Kanye beats. You don't even get money from Kanye. You know the truth, my nigga.
No, bro.
That's like 10 years ago, my nigga.
Dark Paradise?
He didn't get nothing.
I don't get nothing. I don't follow Big Sean no more. Saha don't get nothing. I'll give you that. Saha be getting the back ghost credits, though.
He's a rapper. He's still eating. He wanted to
rap. He's still... Yeah, man. Saha, I don't know, man. But Saha ain't even that mad though, cause he don't be acting out like your other.
Consequence ain't never said nothing.
I ain't talking about that. I'm talking about
that's a team of Ghost Fighters. With a nigga claiming he top two and he's not two. I would complain too.
Anyway. This is our review of My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy. Again, a legend when it dropped and a legend standing in time. And people recognize that. And I'm glad that people recognize that. I know JC was like, hey, man, we got to put this out there for the people. So we put it out there.
That's a credible album.
Any last words, JC?
Nicki had the best verse on Monster. I want you niggas to get into the social media and shit on this nigga closer for saying Jay-Z. Like, don't show no mercy on this nigga. Call this nigga out, and I want Black Twitter to cancel the nigga. I'm gonna be honest.
Wow. I will say the best verse on the album was probably Pusha's Runaway verse. I like that. And then I told you
that
I
verse.
Lied for Jigga. I don't know about verse, but I just like that line. I didn't say verse,
said,
but I meant,
we heard
you know, really the line from that line, dog. So
Nicki wrote it.
And you still can't tell me who wrote that Nicki verse.
Safari
so
can't rap.
Point. Yeah, okay. That don't matter. A lot of niggas can't do a lot, but they'll write. They'll write you something beautiful.
They're
though.
Righteous.
So, anyway, everybody, stay blessed, stay positive. We out.